Good morning, I'm Patrick Lavery, and for Eric Scott on this Wednesday, April 27th, 2022, Chief Meteorologist Dan Zarrow says we are turning cooler after last night's rain, even a frost or freeze possible overnight tonight as lows dip into the 30s. Before that, sun and clouds today, chance of a sprinkle, so a little bit of everything, and Dan breaks it down in his weather blog at nj1015.com. Harassment, vandalism, and assaults targeting Jewish people hit a new high in the Garden State last year, according to new data from the Anti-Defamation League, which in a new report is particularly concerned with the 44 recorded anti-Semitic incidents that took place at Jewish institutions, and 82 incidents were reported in non-Jewish K-12 schools. State police say a Brooklyn man has been arrested after a shooting incident at the American Dream Mega Mall left one man hurt earlier this month. On Monday, 20-year-old Anwar Stewart was arrested at his New York home. The isolated incident on April 7th prompted a brief but chaotic lockdown. Police officers may have suffered career-ending injuries, say authorities in Nassau County, Long Island, after two 16-year-olds and a 17-year-old suspect, all from Newark, are accused of ramming their police vehicles with a stolen car over the weekend. Five cops were hurt in total. The teens were arrested and are charged with, among other crimes, assault and grand larceny. Woodland Park, the former West Paterson and Passaic County, the latest Jersey municipality to go against the state attorney general's memo clearing off-duty police officers to use recreational marijuana following last week's launch. The mayor of Woodland Park simply saying the municipal anti-drug use policy has not changed and it won't. A third suspect has been arrested in Raleigh, North Carolina, connected to the murder last month of a man in his hometown of North Plainfield. 23-year-old Jose Branch is the latest to be charged in the shooting death of 26-year-old Steve Camino on March 1st. Branch joins two other men from Piscataway and Plainfield, now in the Somerset County lockup. State judicial officials are working on an alternative to a bill passed by the Assembly that would deny bail to most people accused of gun crimes. The judiciary is talking with the Attorney General's Office, Public Defender's Office, and American Civil Liberties Union of New Jersey to devise ways to enhance how people accused of gun offenses are treated. Also this morning, a busy Tuesday for authorities in Trenton who start their day on Tuesday thwarting a bank robbery at a Wells Fargo branch in the North Trenton section. NJ.com reports a man armed with a handgun entered the bank just after it opened, pointed the weapon at an employee and demanded cash, but an off-duty cop working security there quickly subdued 23-year-old Samir Queen. And Tuesday night in New Jersey's capital city, a Trenton firefighter grazed by gunfire while working outside the firehouse on Calhoun Street. The stray bullet left the fireman's arm wounded. He was last listed in stable condition. An investigation is ongoing. Now, we've sent inquiries to city officials for more on both of those incidents out of Trenton yesterday. The CDC now estimates 3 in 4 kids have been infected with the coronavirus. Researchers also saying more than half of all Americans have shown signs of previous infections. The CDC examined blood samples from more than 200,000 people looking for virus-fighting antibodies made from actual infections, not the COVID vaccines. More than a dozen different serious diseases are the target of recommended vaccines for children, both in the Garden State and in the United States as a whole. And New Jersey health officials are urging families to catch up on the vaccines that are typically considered routine but may have taken a backseat during the last 2 years of the COVID pandemic. Vice President Kamala Harris has tested positive for COVID. Neither President Biden nor First Lady Jill Biden considered to be a close contact. Harris returned to Washington Monday from a week on the West Coast. She last saw the president on Monday the 18th. She is asymptomatic but is taking the Pfizer antiviral pill Paxlovid. The head of the State Department of Military and Veterans Affairs disclosed there is a third investigation looking into the high number of COVID deaths in veterans' homes in the early days of the pandemic. Investigations by federal and state prosecutors began in October 2020, but lawmakers seemed surprised to learn of this particular third inquiry. Now, how would you like $36 million? Okay, well, you can't get all of it, but NJ.com reports the New Jersey Turnpike Authority has reached an agreement to pay for 3 years' worth of credit card processing fees instead of passing them on to EasyPass users, which means if you pay for your tag with credit or debit, you could be seeing some relief. That's the latest from the New Jersey 101.5 Newsroom on this Wednesday. I'm Patrick Lavery. Like and share this video throughout the day to keep the conversation going. Tune to New Jersey 101.5 all day long for engaging talk and latest traffic and weather. Go to nj1015.com anytime for the latest news. And remember to download our free app and have a great day.